I love dystopian fiction, and I love playing with the hallmarks of that genre. So I knew I wanted to write a dystopia originally because dystopia is great because it pushes characters to extremes. Like, and I really like seeing what characters do when they're under extreme pressure. It pushes them to the limit of their physical and mental strength. Often they're literally fighting to survive. So you're dealing with, big extreme concepts, and I find that fascinating in terms of character development. But one thing I noticed about dystopias over the years is that they're often just set in one small place. So it's like one city or one country. And often that's the point because it's like an isolated community. And that's often why it becomes dystopian, because it's cut off from the outside world. So something like, Chicago in Divergent, for example. But I wanted to combine that with my other favourite genre, which is epic fantasy. So I liked the idea of taking the classic features of a dystopia, but expanding it to a global story. So having a dystopia that was set in more than one place, that goes to different cities, that goes across oceans, and you see the dystopia both from the inside and the outside. So for example, one of the questions I was always asking myself when I read The Hunger Games is, why is no one commenting on the fact that America is, sending children to die in this bizarre gladiator trial? And that was the question I was always asking myself. You never get to hear about what the rest of the world is like in The Hunger Games, and that's one of the questions I wanted to ask with The Bone Season. What would a dystopia look like if you could see the whole world? I suppose it was a number of different reasons. One of the things I wanted to do with The Bone Season was essentially to write about a modern day witch trial. The leader of the dystopian government is called a Grand Inquisitor, and it's kind of similar to the witch trials in some ways. People who are considered magical or different are the ones who are being persecuted. And I found it interesting to look at a government like that, but also to examine it very closely internally. So again, something that you often see in dystopias, you don't really get to see the behind the scenes sometimes. The leaders are kind of shadowy figures, and you don't know what exactly is driving them and the different contradictions within that machine, that system. I wanted to again examine the different layers of power within that totalitarian government. So the politicians who disagree with each other, for example, and the idea of a puppet government, and who is really the puppet here, who's controlling who. And that's in a way why the series has to be so long. It's one of the reasons, because I just love getting really deep into that system and interrogating it. So for example, in the fourth book, there's a scene where a character actually breaks into one of the politicians' home, and you see that he has a family life. He's this essentially a very monstrous character. He does terrible, callous things, but then he can also go home and he has like a wife and children. And that's another thing that fascinates me, that these people are human. They do monstrous things, but they can also kind of compartmentalize those things. And I was really interested in that. Well, it was natural to me to write a female character because when I wrote The Bone Season, I was a 19-year-old woman myself. And when the character came into my head, she was also a 19-year-old young woman. And it was just easy to slip into that character, I suppose. And it wasn't, I suppose it wasn't really, at the beginning, there wasn't really any other reason than that. It was just because she was a character who was similar to me in that regard, and there was not really a reason to make her a male character, I suppose. That's just how she came into my head as a young woman. But I suppose it is still very exciting to have stories about young women, being able to assert themselves and to have power. That's very exciting, and how power affects them. I also wanted to go really deep into the character's psyche as well. Like, I wanted to look at, she is, fighting and powerful, and she has this rare ability. But I also wanted to look at how that affects her negatively. So she goes through all of this trauma in the books to try to defeat this government, but it has a massive effect on her personally. It really takes its toll mentally and physically on her. And I wanted to really do that justice, I suppose. I wanted to make sure that she feels like a very real character who is vulnerable as well. I don't actually find it all that thrilling when I see characters who are again, this kind of strong female characters idea that they have to be these unbreakable kind of warriors who never show any emotion and who never fail and never feel weak or vulnerable. I don't really like that personally. I'm more interested in a character who does great things but also has moments of weakness, who makes mistakes, who does have flaws, and who does feel the effects of what they're doing. She's not indestructible. It's lovely to be able to sit with that one character across seven books and just really look at how all the things she's doing are changing her.